If we were to buy the stock for $50, so this is a situation where we're buying the stock, we're clearly putting $50 up front. And if the stock moved up to $80 and we were able to perfectly call the top and sell it for that $80, we would make a $30 profit off of a $50 initial investment. So that's a 60% gain. That's a 60% gain on our upfront capital. Now on the other side, if the stock were to go down to $20, we would lose $30 of our $50 upfront investment. So it would be a 60% loss. So in the buying the stock, based on the scenario that I painted, we could gain 60% or we could lose 60%. And in terms of the potential upside, you can gain an unlimited amount because the stock can just really go to any possible value. And in terms of loss, when you buy a stock, the most you can lose is 100%. Now let's think about the scenario with the call option. To buy the call option, it only cost us $5. So we only had to put $5 up front. And in the scenario where the stock went up to $80, we figured out that we were able to profit $15 net of the price of the option. So this was our pure profit. So on a base of a $5 investment, we were able to get $15 of profit. So we were able to get a 300% gain. On the other side, though, if the stock went down, we had no reason to actually exercise our option. So we essentially just lost all of the money of the option. So we lost 100%. And what I want to show here is that what an option did is it gave us leverage. And the term comes from physics because a lever will give you kind of mechanical leverage. It can allow you to exert more force than you otherwise could by using that simple tool. And a call option is giving you financial leverage. You're essentially making the same bet here, but you're multiplying your potential gain or your potential loss. If the stock, based on the scenario we painted, in the good scenario, you made 60%. But in the call option, in the good scenario, you made 300%. We multiplied our gain. But on the downside, with the stock, we lost 60%. But with the call option, we lost 100%. So once again, we multiplied our loss. And right here, it looks like the numbers are still favorable because our loss multiplication wasn't as much as our gain multiplication. But this is really based on some of the numbers I chose. But the important thing to realize is if you're dealing with an option to essentially make the same bet, that the bet that the company will go up, you're just putting leverage on your bet. You're multiplying your potential gains or losses.